This Disney DVD is enhanced with Disney's FastPlay. Your movie and a selection of bonus features will begin automatically. To bypass FastPlay, select the main menu button at any time. FastPlay will begin in a moment.
Hey, Joe, look who's here.
Well, what do you know? It's a butcher.
Oh, this is the night.
For the first time ever, on a two-disc special edition DVD, Walt Disney's original classic, Lady and the Tramp.
What a beautiful little lady.
What a dog.
He's a tramp. But they love him.
Now with picture and sound digitally restored beyond its original brilliance.
It sounds wonderful.
Critics call it one of Disney's most enduring classics.
Open up your eyes to what a dog's life can really be.
Walt Disney proudly presents Lady and the Tramp. For the first time ever on a two-disc special edition DVD, February 28th, 2006.
Which you can watch on Disney Channel.
Hey, surfers. Rose here with the whole gang, Josh, Tessa, and Jaren.
We're taking an exclusive Movie Surfers sneak peek at two of Disney's upcoming movies.
Plus, you'll see an early look at some of the Movie Surfers segments we're already working on.
First up is The Wild, a new computer animated movie about a young lion from the New York City Zoo who is accidentally shipped to the wilds of Africa. So his dad and some of their zoo friends make their way through the concrete jungles of New York to find the real jungles of Africa to rescue the missing cub. And surfers, you'll get to see what really happens in the zoo once all the humans leave.
The zoo will officially be ours in T-minus 3, 2...
Ready, and...
And I got the chance to meet the director and one of the animators of the film.
This is a huge, huge adventure. We basically are in New York City, the ocean, in the jungle. The villain in our film is a wildebeest played by William Shatner.
Bring us those lions!
He's done a fantastic job at really sounding evil.
No longer will we dwell at the bottom of the food chain.
The Wild is coming to theaters soon.
Next up, Tim Allen stars in Disney's new movie, The Shaggy Dog.
Of course, you probably remember Tim Allen from the Santa Claus movies.
Only this time, he doesn't turn into Old Saint Nick. He turns into, well, a shaggy dog.
Oh, he bit me.
Shit.
And the surfers get to sit down with Tim to talk about the movie. So, Tim, can you tell us who you play in the movie?
I'm a dog, man. I'm Shaggy Dog.
What would you say is the hardest part about being a dog?
Dogs are constantly distracted by odors.
And the surfers get to hang out with some of the animals from the movie.
This is Cole.
So what tricks did this dog do in the movie?
He's had to type on a computer.
How do you teach a dog to type on a computer?
We taught him to hold a pencil in his mouth. And then we taught him to put his head down and his head up.
Good, head up. Head down.
It's quite a zoo on set.
The Shaggy Dog is coming to theaters soon.
So, surfers, there you have it, your Movie Surfer sneak peek.
And remember to catch more of Disney's Movie Surfers on Disney Channel, where we go behind the scenes of the latest Disney movies coming to theaters.
Nita?
Kenai?
So who's Nita?
She's the girl I used to know.
Who needs girls?
The legend of Brother Bear continues in an all-new movie. And these guys...
How's it going, eh?
Beauty, eh?
...still don't have a clue.
It's that time of year, eh?
Spring fever.
Yeah, you know, like the birds...
Yeah, and the bees.
...and the moosets.
Bye!
We gotta go work out.
Yeah, gotta keep these muscles real buff, eh?
Come on!
This summer, no matter how hard they try to get along...
We're still getting a brush up from those moosettes.
So we thought we'd appeal to their olfactory sense.
Ew.
I got news for you, little brother. That wasn't mud.
Guys and girls are totally different animals.
Bravery. That's what really impresses the ladies.
Everything goes for himself. Oh.
Act like we're not here.
That went well.
From the great north comes a new adventure.
You are the wisest shaman.
Sha-woman, okay? Wise and man don't even belong in the same sentence.
Brother Bear 2.
I'm a hoof man. Yours are nice and shiny.
Hoof man. Why didn't I think of that?
All new on Disney DVD this August.
Ow! Ow! Got it. It was so fun.
Yeah, really.
Blah, blah, blah. I was so excited.
Yeah, I'm very excited. Is that so?
I've seen Bambi 1.
The original Bambi is the inspiration for our film.
It's really fun to be part of the sequel to it.
It was very intimidating in the beginning to start working on that, and the only way I could see doing it is to be as true as we possibly could to it.
Come along.
I remember getting started on it. I was actually thinking, I don't think I can do this. I mean, I've been animating for almost 25 years now, but it's a big deal. It's just a big deal.
It's all right, you'll get it.
I think we were doing something that everybody said you couldn't do.
It's probably the most, you know, endearing and revered movie Disney has, practically.
Bambi.
And then you take a deep breath, and you walk away from your desk, and you get a cup of coffee, and then you come back. And then you start, and then it's so joyful.
If you're late again, I'll have no choice but to... What was that?
What was what?
I guess it was my stomach.
Oh, I can't define it because I'm not an artist. I can't draw anything. But there is in the line something which suggests that there is something that's living. Because they are alive, and it's entirely to do with the line of the art.
Bambi? Isn't that a girl's name?
He doesn't look like any normal old deer, you know? He looks smarter than that. He's like...
Walt Disney always told his animators, you have to learn how to draw the real thing first, and then you can animate it.
We really want to emulate that realism. And the original crew, the Bambi crew, they did exactly this. The same thing, so I'm very, very excited to be here today and study like the old guys did.
And don't forget the gigantic forehead, you know, to add that baby formula. And there goes Bambi right now. How does Bambi sneeze? It's like he's like a little kid. And you just can't have it broad. So my first attempt was, chew. And it just looked wrong. It didn't look right for the character. So I'm having something much more subtle. So in doing this, where his head is moving just a little bit, it worked a lot better.
So this is the way I'm going about it now. But, I mean, all those things require such observation by the animators, not just of the animal, but kids. Because you have to combine that, you know, the kids' world and the animal world.
That's it!
Oops. Okay.
The deer constantly were coming up to the sketch pads and eating them. I think it was like their way of critiquing the artwork. So they didn't like something, they ate it. One of the things we tried to maintain from the first movie is the artistry that went into the backgrounds.
They're beautiful. The backgrounds are my favorite. Well, the original were oil paintings, and so we've used digital technique to replicate that process.
And they're painted by hand. Believe me, there's somebody that sat there and they painted it stroke for stroke. It's just that we did it using digital programs instead of using a paintbrush and oil paint and turpentine and all the stuff that goes with it.
All of these people are traditional painters. You know, they all have private fine gallery showings of their own work. It's just using a different kind of a brush and a different kind of a piece of paper.
Bumper! Bambi! Boy, am I glad to see you.
What's wrong?
They've been after me all morning.
Who has?
Oh, big brother! It's terrible. It's horrible. It's damn!
I was so impressed by the quality of the acting and the voices, and I asked Brian, I said, how did you find these kids?
We did countless numbers of auditions for Thumper and for Bambi.
My name is Brendan Barrick as Thumper.
And he is a bundle of energy.
Hello, you microphone.
He gets so wound up and so excited, and he's a great kid.
What the heck? Being brave is easy. I can teach you.
You can?
Sure. Watch this.
Grr.
All it takes is one good grr.
Off my property,
you trespassing hooligans.
Yes, I'm doing the voice of the porcupine and the brown hog.
Oh, why me? My nerves just can't take it anymore.
I had done the temporary dialogue for our early screenings.
It actually turned out that everybody fell madly in love with both of those characters, and so he ended up being the actual voice in the movie.
Oh, yeah.
Boo.
The voice of Bambi, Alexander Gould, is an amazingly talented young man who also did the voice of Nemo for Finding Nemo.
I can do a line for you. It's like, well, my father never takes me with him anymore.
A great voice and a great read like we have on this one gives us so much to work with, so much inspiration, and the scenes almost animate themselves.
I guess I'm not what a Princess Son is supposed to be. But if I could just show him that I can be brave, like him. Yeah, and I don't have to have people going, when they see me on the streets going, Alexander, I want your autograph, give me your autograph, you know? So it's a lot nicer like that, too.
I see.
The biggest, most wonderful thing about the movie is Patrick Stewart as the Great Prince. He is such a consummate professional.
And he gives such an inner life to and a meaning to everything he says.
It was one of man's tricks.
I'm sorry.
What if I hadn't gotten there in time? You could have been...
Somebody once said that comedy is a very serious business. Because finally the story is a humorous story as we follow Bambi through his growing maturity. If there is not behind it the fundamental seriousness of living, then you diminish the comic aspect of it.
She's never coming back, is she?
No.
As I recall, certainly in terms of emotion, there was nothing more intense than Bambi. It's just quality storytelling, the most gorgeous themes in Bambi, and it's so completely genuine. You don't see stories being told like that anymore. That are so honest.
Bambi.
Mother? It's so super awesome, cool. And now I can tell my kids, like, I'm Bambi. I was Bambi. I mean, not the original Bambi, but I was Bambi.
It's very gratifying in one's 60s to find oneself part of this extraordinary legend.
Yeah. a masterpiece.
Bumper!
Call me Mama. Go. See ya.
I can tell you being an animator is a wonderful job because there's nothing like seeing your own drawings come to life.
It's easy. I can teach you.
You can?
Sure. Watch this.
So if any of you are interested in animation, trying animation or becoming an animator, let me tell you, you should draw a lot.
You're gonna need a lot of practice.
Maybe you start drawing your pets, your dog or your cat, or draw your parents, brothers and sisters. You just need to observe a lot and have a lot of fun drawing.
See?
Thumper is a really fun to draw and easy to draw character. He is so round. There are no angles on him. You know, he has his little chubby belly here and that little face is all, the cheeks come out here. And so he's a kind of a simple character to draw.
What can I say? I'm a born storyteller.
I'm going to demonstrate that for you right now. Again, Thumper, you can pretty much be sure you can draw him just with circles and ovals. There's not a lot of difficult or complicated angles. Here I'm drawing his head, just a circle, and then this would be his body. I'm not going to do any details yet, but I'm thinking I should probably do the ears now because they're such a big part of a rabbit. So in case of Thumper, one ear is drooping down, the other one goes way up. And then I'll take it from here. I have a nice little angle for his forehead. And then a really cute button nose like this. Again, it's pretty round. Then, of course, the eye. He's got these very expressive, large eyes. The eyebrows, gotta have those. And then I want to give him a nice, happy smile. Thumper's always in a good mood. So I'm going to give him a happy expression right there. Open mouth, big, expressive eyes. And then these are his sort of soft, chubby cheeks. They are very soft. And again, I'm doing this all with round lines like this. And then I'm going to go down here and do his shoulder area. Again, that's a circle and a soft little elbow. Yeah, so there's one paw like this. The other paw I'm just going to take from the other side a little longer. And we are going to have his knee just about here, and the other one on the other side. And then I would add one foot sort of coming at us like this. Of course, all rabbits have big feet.
Wake up, flower, wake up!
And the other one I'm going to take all the way out here to show how long it is. Because you all know how high he can hop, so he's got to have big legs, big feet. Like that. And then, guess what I forgot? His tail.
Well, you gotta see it!
So that would be, of course, over here. Just a circle, and we fluff that up a little bit. And there we have our favorite Disney rabbit, Thumper. Thank you very much for watching and joining me here in my home studio, and have fun drawing. You know, it just takes a paper and a pencil.
And remember what I taught you.
Get ready for the biggest adventure five little pups ever had. So run, don't walk, for Disney's all-new adventure. From the doghouse to your house. Air Buddies, the all-new movie, coming soon to Disney DVD. This time, it's all in the family.
One classic Disney movie showed us the magic of everlasting friendship.
I'm a fox. My name's Todd.
My name's Copper. I'm a hound dog.
And now,
we'll always be friends forever.
Forever.
The story that critics call absolutely marvelous continues. Walt Disney Pictures presents The Fox and the Hound 2, an all-new motion picture.
Come on, kids, sing with us.
Welcome to the band, kid.
Now, a friendship will be tested.
What's eating you?
Ever since you've joined that band, you've changed. You're never around anymore. It's either them or me.
But some new friends must try to bring them back together.
Give me a backbeat.
Bread down home to sweet harmony.
Featuring the voice talents and music of Grammy Award winner Reba McEntire and Patrick Swayze.
We're in harmony.
The Fox and the Hound 2, an all-new movie premiering on Disney DVD, winter 2006.
It was fun.
Christopher Robin.
Out of the Disney vault, it's grand indeed and wonderfully charming. Pooh's Grand Adventure.
Hiya, Pooh.
A.A. Milne's classic story comes to life.
Christopher Robin! Are you looking for him too?
Available for the first time ever on DVD in honor of Pooh's anniversary celebration.
Oh, Christopher Robin! He has gone to the great unknown. We must help him get back. Adventure is a wonderful thing.
Don't miss this treasured tale about one of the most enduring friendships of all time.
You must remember, you're braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think.
It's a classic you'll cherish forever.
Just in time for the best part of the day.
What part is that?
The part when you and me become we.
Disney presents Pooh's Grand Adventure, coming soon to Disney DVD.
The mission is over. The universe safe.
Lilo and Stitch, you have successfully captured all 625 of Jumba's genetic experiments, turned them from bad to good, and found each a place where it can belong.
It's time for good friends to say goodbye.
You belong out in space. I'll miss you too.
Now a new evil experiment will bring them back together. Something masterfully diabolical, hideously ugly, and incredibly stinky.
I shall name you Leroy!
Leroy?
You can join the fight for the galaxy in an all-new movie, Leroy and Stitch, coming soon to Disney DVD.
Every day inside Playhouse Disney, only on Disney Channel, twist and turn, imagine and learn with JoJo's Circus.
Here we go.
It's full of fun.
Whoa!
Encourages kids to move about.
First you bend forward. Wow, what a bow.
And teaches a great lesson in every show.
I learned that no matter what, always do your best.
JoJo's Circus, every morning inside Playhouse Disney, only on Disney Channel.
Thumper and his sisters love to play together, but sometimes Thumper needs a rest. It's a little game he calls Thumper. neighbors hurry and scurry. His sisters close their eyes and count to 10 while Thumper runs away, hides, and then his sisters try to find him. Would you like to play too? Great! If you'd like to play on your own, press 1 player. Or if you'd like to play with someone else, press 2 players. No matter where Thumper hides, you can be sure his sisters will search high and low to find him. Use your remote control to navigate through the forest and try to find where Thumper may be hiding. Ready or not, let's play! There are lots of places to hide in the woods. Any choice will do. Try again. Thumper's sisters really miss him. Try again. Thumper's sisters really miss him. Go ahead and make... Keep going. Thumper's sisters will never give up. No Thumper there. Better try again fast. Nice try. I guess Thumper really doesn't want to get caught this time. Whoops! Thumper didn't expect you to find him that fast. Select play again if you'd like to play.